Good morning, students. Welcome back to this algorithm class again. In today's class, we are going to see some examples of this greedy method. In the last class, we have been discussing about this greedy method. What is the greedy method? It's a problem-solving strategy. It cannot be applied for all the problems. It is suitable for the problems for which the answer can be found out in stages. Okay, so in the greedy method, solve the problems that are solved using this greedy method usually will have n number of inputs, and there will be an objective function and constraints involved. From the given n inputs, you have to select the items for the solution, and the selected item from the given n elements should satisfy the constraints, and they should maximize the objective function value. Okay, like this, we can generate several subsets from the given n elements. Each subset is called as a feasible set, and out of these feasible sets, which feasible set is giving the maximum objective function value, then that is the optimal solution. That's what we have discussed in the last class. Even if you couldn't understand that yesterday's class very well, just follow today's example, here you will understand. Also, I told you that the greedy method can solve the problem in two ways. One is subset paradigm problem and order paradigm problem. In the subset paradigm problem, not all the given n inputs are taken for the solution. Only a subset of that is taken for the solution. In the order paradigm problem, all the inputs are taken for solution, but they are rearranged in a particular fashion so that the final solution is arrived. That is order paradigm problem. Now we are going to discuss about one problem called a knapsack problem that is solved using this greedy method. This knapsack problem comes under subset paradigm greedy method. Because this problem will have n inputs and not all the n inputs are taken for the solution. Only a subset of that problem, n inputs are taken for the solution. Okay. It's taken for the solution. Okay. Now let us dive into this knapsack problem. Knapsack problem. Okay. Problem description. What is this problem? In this problem, you are given n inputs. Given n objects and a knapsack with a capacity of some m units, okay. Excuse me. Each object has a profit and a weight. Each object has the profit value PI and weight value. WI, that is P1 is the profit for the first item, P2 is the profit for the second item, PN is the profit for the nth item, like that W1, W2, W3, WN are the weights for the given N items. Okay. Now, what we have to do is, we have to fill up this knapsack from the given items such that you get the maximum value stored in the knapsack. That is the objective. The objective fill up the knapsack. Fill up the knapsack with the objects. Such that the knapsack has maximum value of items. Maximum value of items. That is the problem. Now you try to understand this problem very well. Unless you understand this problem, you cannot appreciate this problem, and you cannot understand the greedy approach for this problem. What are the problems is, given n objects and a knapsack with a capacity of m. Each object has a profit value PI and a weight WI, and the weight value WI. Fill up the knapsack with the object such that the knapsack has maximum value of items. Okay. Now consider this situation. You are going to a vegetable market and you are carrying a bag with you, and you are asked to buy some vegetables from the vegetable market. Let us take the bag capacity is 50 kg. The bag you are holding is having 50 kg of, can have a 50 kg of items. That is the capacity. That means you can hold only 50 kg of items in that bag. Now you go to the vegetable market. There you see various vegetables. They are all available in various baskets. Basket one might have beetroot, some 30 kgs of beetroots are there in the basket, and weight per kg is 20 rupees. 1 kg of beetroot is 20 rupees. Then another basket has some onion, and there are some 40 kg of onions are there, and cost of the onion per kg is 15 rupees. Like this, various vegetables are there, some amount of various amounts of vegetables are there, and each vegetable is having a cost associated with that. Now, the problem now here is, you have to fill up the bag you are holding with the maximum amount, maximum value of items. That is, you might get some half kg from the onion and put that into that bag. Then you might get 1 kg of tomato. You might get half kg of drumstick. Like this, you are putting all those things in the bag. And when your bag got filled up, you calculate the value of the items that are in the bag. Okay. By choosing optimally the objects, the vegetables from the market, you should ensure that the final value of items in that bag should be maximum. Should be maximum. If that is so, in what order you should select the vegetables from the market such that the bag you are holding has maximum value of items. That is this knapsack problem. So with that understanding, you look at this description again. You are given n objects and a knapsack with a capacity of m. Each object has a profit value PI and a weight value WI. Fill up the knapsack with the objects such that the knapsack has a maximum value of items. So you correlate this problem description with the example I have given, that is going to the vegetable market and given. So given n objects, so in the vegetable market some 10 vegetables are there, and you are having a bag of 50 kg, you are having a bag of capacity 50 kg. Each object has a profit value, that is drumstick has the cost of 30 rupees per kg, and weight value some 100 kg of drumsticks are there in the market. Then onion is having some 25 rupees per kg. Like that, some 75 kg of items, onions are there in the market, like this. Now fill up the knapsack, fill up your bag with the objects, vegetables, so such that your bag has a maximum value of vegetables. That is the problem. Okay. How will you select this items? Okay. How will you select the item? That is the problem description. How are you going to select? Now, example problem, example. Example, okay. Let us take, when you go to the market, there are only 3 items. N is equal to 3 items are there. And your knapsack capacity, your bag capacity is 20, and that means only there are three objects are there, and the bag you are holding is having a capacity of 20 kg. Okay, then P1 comma P2 comma P3, the profit of each items are let us take 25, 24, 15. That is profit end of first item is 25, profit end of second item is 24, profit end of third item is 15. Okay. Now, let us consider the weight of each item. Okay, W1, W2, comma W3 equal to, let us take 18, 15, 10. 18, comma 15, comma 10. That is 18 kg of first item is available, 15 kg of second item is available, 19 kg of third item is available. Profit of the first item is 25 rupees, profit of the second item is 24 rupees, profit of the third item is okay. Now the problem is, how are you going to fill up this knapsack such that you get the maximum profit? You get the maximum profit. So that is the answer we are going to get. How are you going to do this? Okay. Can we select items in any order? There should be a particular order, then only you should get you should get the maximum profit. Then only you will get the maximum profit. Okay. Let us approach various methods. Okay. Let us select items randomly. Let us items select randomly. Let us see how much of profit, how much of gain we are getting. Okay. Let me create a table for this. Insert table. Order of item. Okay. Then sum of weight. Then let us take profit end. This is end. Now I select items in some random order. I select items in random order. Okay. Let me take some 1/2 of the first item. 1/2 of the first item. Then one by two of the first item, then I take 1/3 of the second item, then I take 1/4 of the third item. 1/2 of the first item, 1/3 of the second item, and 1/4 of the third item. Let us take. Then what is the sum of weight that I put in the bag? Sum of weight that I put in the bag. That is, what is the weight of the first item? 18 kg. So out of 18 kg, I take 1/2 of the 18 kg. So it is 18 into 1/2, then 18 into 1/2. Then what is the weight of the second item? 15 kg. How much I am taking? 1/3 of the second item. So 15 into 1/3 plus, then what is the weight of the third item? 19 kg. How much I am taking? 1/4. So 19 into 1/4. So what is the final answer? What is the final answer? This is 18 into 1/2 into 18 when you divide the 18 by 2, you get 9. Then 15 into 3, 15 by 3, 5. Then it is 1 by 4. So it becomes, so it is 9 plus 3, 9 plus, yeah, 5 times, okay. It is 9 plus 5, 14. Then altogether it comes to 16.5. What is that? 16.5. Okay. 19 into 1 by 4. It comes to 16.5. What is the profit I am earning? Okay. The value of the first profit is 25. Okay. So 25 into 1 by 2. 25 into 1 by 2 plus, what is the profit of the second item? 24. 24 into how much of the second item I am taking? 1/3. So 1 by 3 plus, what is the profit of the third item? 15. How much I am taking? 1 by 4 into 1 by 4. So when you calculate these things, it comes to 24.25. Okay. So this is the profit I am getting when I select items in some random order. Okay. Now, I copy this table. Okay. Now I select an item in some other order. Okay. Here also I put a table. Okay. What is the order? Let us take, I select item in the decreasing order of profit. That is, I select the item having the first highest profit, then I select item having the next highest profit, like this, decreasing profit. Decreasing profit. Okay. Decreasing profit means, then which is the item having the highest profit? First item, 25, is having the highest profit. So what is the, how much of first item is available? 18 kg of item is available. What is the capacity of my knapsack? 20. So I select all the 18 kgs of the first item. So I select all the items means entire item of the first item is selected. Whole of first item is selected. That is one. Okay. Then how much of the capacity is remaining? Out of 20 kg, I have selected 18 kgs. Still, I have only 2 kgs left to fill up my knapsack. So what is the next highest profit item? The second item is having 24, highest profit. Okay, how much of item is available, weight is available? 15 kg. So out of this 15 kg, I have to select 2 kg. I have to select 2 kg. So I select 2 by 15 of the second item. After selecting these two items, my knapsack got full. So because whole of the first item, 18 kg is selected, second item, 15 kg is available. 15 into 2 by 15, 15 gets cancelled. I am left with only 2 kg. So 18 plus 2 is equal to 20. That means I don't select any of the third item. In that case, what is the weight I acquire, sum of weight is equal to 1, sum of weight is equal to whole of the first, that is whole quantity, isn't it? So 1 into 18 kg, 1 into 18 kg plus, then how much of the second item I am selecting? 2 by 15. So 2 by 15 of the second item, how much is available? 15 kg is available, plus 0 of the third item. How much of the third item? What is the weight? 19. 0 into 19, that is equal to, so 1 into 18, 18, 2 by 15 into 15, 15, 15 gets cancelled, 2. So 18 plus 2 is equal to all the 20 kgs are selected. Now, what is the profit I am earning? What is the profit I am earning? Profit earned is equal to whole of the first item into, what is the profit of the first item? 25. So 25 plus, how much of the second item is selected? 2 by 15. So 2 by 15 into, what is the profit of the second item? 24. It is 24 plus, how much of the third item is selected? 0. What is the profit of the third item? 15. This you don't have to do it still. Let us see. So it is 25 plus, it is 25 plus 2 by 15 into 24, you will get some value, and this is 0. So when you solve this one, you will get this as 3.2. It becomes 3.2. So 25 plus 3.2, it becomes 28.2. It becomes 28.2. It becomes 28.2. Okay. Now, next, we have to select items in the order of, maybe in some other order, that we will see in the next class. Time is getting short, that we will see in the next class. We will continue this problem in the next class. Okay.